But first, Amy Stenser takes a stand in her own defense. She broke down as she testified, telling her story for the first time. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Jennifer Griswold spoke with the defense attorney who is familiar with the case to break it down for us, and he had some interesting takes on this.
Well, Leah, first of all, Amy Stenser said she was terrified when she took the stand, but she said she finally gets to speak. She says she took her daughters to a concert in St. Paul. She wasn't feeling well and decided to go home, but then changed her mind. She was trying to turn around when she hit Anison Panthavong.
Cameras have shown Amy Stenser for months, but we've never heard her tell what happened until today. A tearful Stenser described she was exiting 94, but looking to her left at a closed bridge under construction when, quote, I remember being jolted back to the front and not quite sure what happened. I was not quite sure if I hit a pothole or a construction sign. Defense attorney Eric Nelson asked, at the time of that impact, did you know that you had hit Mr. Panthavong? Stenser answered no. But the question is whether the jury believes her.
I think she needs to earn the credibility of the jury because I think this whole trial has been about nothing but her character.
Defense attorney Bruce Rivers is not involved but has sat in the courtroom for part of the trial. Prosecutors pointed out contradictions in Stenser's statements, such as whether she suffers from migraines.
And when you contradict your testimony, the jury can look at it and say, if I don't believe you about one thing, I'm not going to believe you about everything.
The defense offered their own reconstructionist to counter the state's. The defense's witness says Anison Panthavong wasn't standing and therefore could have been tough to see.
Regardless of whether the person was standing or bending over in the motion to fill a gas cap, you're still hitting somebody that's well over 100 pounds. You're still hitting something that's heavy.
Amy Stenser is charged with 3 counts, leaving the scene, failing to call for help, and a 3rd charge alleging gross negligence. The jury is expected to get the case as soon as tomorrow.
Okay, the prosecutors also asked some questions today about the text messages that were deleted, and Amy Stenser didn't have the ticket to the concert that night. How did she explain some of those things?
Okay, so Amy Stenser says that she deleted her text messages from that night. She said she does that often, so she said that was not unusual. Okay. As for the ticket, she said that was likely in her jeans from that night. Now, she says she took the clothes she was wearing that night to Goodwill. She said she did that because she was never going to wear those clothes again.
Wow. Well, the jury will likely get this case tomorrow, so it'll be interesting to see what they do with it.
Start unfolding.
All right, thanks, Jenny.